me start. What is what on screen? The terms and terminology used in the Revit software. And without this terms and terminology, it's difficult to deal with the software, because if you don't know what is what, and if I say, for example, go to particular panel and from the ribbon find out the particular tool. So at this level, you don't know what is ribbon, you don't know what is panel, you don't know this option bar, you don't know this property window, etc. So today we'll learn what is what on screen, the terms and terminology, the very basic. So you see, all this point is given in the notes with the image. The same you'll find in the Revit software also, with few changes in latest version. ठीक है, जो जो changes रहेंगे आपको notes में update करा दूंगा मैं. ठीक है, so directly you can update in the notes itself. So like for example, you see in the previous version you'll find this R button. Can you see this? And this was application menu, but now in the latest version the R icon is a dummy. Instead of this you'll find the file menu. File menu. तो ये एक change है. ठीक है, like this you'll find few changes that you can update with the class. So that we can directly deal with the latest version, which is required in actual practice in interview. So here you see, and in order to install this software, already have given the system configuration in the last class. i3 processor higher is recommended with the 4 GB RAM. Aajkal to common ho gaya na, aajkal when you purchase a laptop you'll get minimum 4 GB with i3 or i5 processor. Even in the dual core processor also you can install. Okay, for practice point of view, if you don't have i3, no problem, you can install in dual core 2 GB RAM also, but it will be very slow. Before starting the project, any project in software, this is a default screen with the three sections. Section 1 is a project section. From directly you can open new the project, existing project. See, this is the default view with the three sections. Section 1 is for project. Directly we can go for new project, this open project, new project and templates. How to use template we'll discuss later. And these are the recent files or the default files. When you open any file, you'll find in the recent files, these are recent files. Okay, below this you'll find the section for families. If you're dealing with the 3D intelligent component, the recent file will be available here with the open, new and some options. The third section is for online help. Directly Revit offers lot of data and including the videos in online. So if the net is connected, you can click this and you can take the help from the online also, reference, quick reference, help files, lot of things. So there's section 3 before opening any project. Okay, now when you open any project, for example, let me open one file. I'm going to open this file. For example, this is a completed one, and why I'm opening this, just to show what is what on screen, the terms and terminology. At this level you are not talking about the project, we are talking about the software screen. Okay, so the first part is the software screen. So we'll talk about the terms and terminology, what is what on screen. Okay, so here you see, when I click here R, I'm getting some minimize, close option. These are basic option, but in the previous version this was application menu, but now in the latest version this R is a dummy. You'll find the separate menu called file, and when you click this, this is called application menu. Why we used to call application menu? Because you see, Revit software is what? Is application software. Like MS Office, AutoCAD, etc. These are all application software. So we can operate this application from this file. Means directly you can close this, or you can go for open, save, print, etc. The major tools or to control the software you'll find under the file. So this is called application menu. Okay, next, on the top here you can find open, save, the synchronize, etc. All this is called quick access toolbar. You can verify in the notes also. You see, quick access and application menu button is given R. Instead of that you can write file here, change the arrow and write file. You'll find the file menu, not this application menu. Left side you can write file and divert the arrow. Next you see quick access toolbar or quick toolbar. Why you used to call? Because you'll find the shortcuts here. But if you want, you can create your own shortcuts in the quick access toolbar. For example, I'm going to click on system. Here you'll find the duct. This duct I want to put under the shortcut. So right click, go for add to quick access toolbar. When you do this, you see, here you'll find the duct in the shortcut, right? Or else if you want, we can remove also, right? Directly you can remove, or if you want any option on this quick access toolbar, right click, add to quick access toolbar, it will be available here. So this is called quick access toolbar. Beside this area, you see, this area you can find the name of the project. So this we can call as a title bar in any software. This is a title bar. Okay, below this here you can find this file, architectural, structural, steel, till this modify, right? All are visible, till modify. So these are all called tabs. We are not used to call menu like AutoCAD. Even in AutoCAD later version, we are getting the 3D annotation view, not classic. If you talk about classic, you will get the menus. Okay, I'll not compare if you don't know AutoCAD. So here you see, these are all called tabs. File is one tab. Sorry, architect is one tab. File is a menu. This is a menu. Okay, because it's dropping down, so we can call this as a menu. But you see, architect is a tab. Similarly, when I click the structure, this also tab, and you can find the tools are changing. Next, steel is a tab, and this steel is a new version in 2019 version. Anyhow, we are not bothered about this because this belongs to the structure side. Anyhow, I'll give you the idea. Next, for MEP services, this system is important. In the system, you'll find HVAC, fabrication, again this mechanical, plumbing, all electrical, all these tools in this. But some basic tool from the architect also will use from this tab. At this level, these are all tabs. Okay, and each tab consists of ribbon. For example, when I click this system, you can find from modify to this work plane, that complete area is called ribbon. Okay, ribbon. Like in typewriter, you'll find the ribbon. Similarly, from here, complete area, this we can call as a ribbon. And each ribbon consists of panels. You see, select is one panel, HVC is one panel, fabrication is one panel, PI, ID, collaboration is one panel, mechanical, all these are all panels. Okay. So this is important because number of times in the notes or in the class also we'll use this. Go to a particular panel, from that panel use that particular tool. So you must know panel. Okay. So ribbon is a set of panels. Okay, and each panel have its own tools. Some tools have direct tool like this, some will have the drop down. Further sub options. So these are drop down tools or these are direct tools. Okay. So once again, tabs, ribbon, under ribbon, panel, under panel you'll find the tools. Okay, simple. And all this you'll find in the notes. You see, this is tab, then below is complete ribbon, and inside these are all panels. It's not written here, but you can go for any one example. You see, this is one panel, these are all 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, all are panels. Okay, so each box with the option is called panel. Okay. Next, below this, here you'll find, at present you see this is blank, nothing now in this. But for example, if I select this conduit, you'll get some information. Similarly, if I select this panel, you'll get some information. Like this, if you select the duct, pipe, or light fixtures, diffuser, anything, based on the selection, you'll get the option here. How to use that option is the next level that we'll discuss when you start the project. So this area is called option bar. Basic editing, basic parameters you'll find here. For example, when I click here, the very basic parameters, distribution system for the electrical panel. Similarly, for example, if I select this duct, you see, you'll get the width and height with the offset. Offset means the level from FFL till the center of duct. At this level, the more at the time of ducting model we'll discuss. And when I select the machine, you'll get the name only mechanical equipment. Or when I select this pipe, you see, you find the dia and offset. So this is called option bar. And option bar, anyhow, ignore that, massive information there. The more, because we have different offset for different component. For example, if you talk about diffuser light fixture, offset means FFL to the bottom. But if you talk about duct and pipe, it's a center of duct or center pipe. But don't worry, we will discuss this point in the respective module. At this level, this area is called option bar. Okay, simple option bar, because you'll get the options. Left side, this is important. This is called property window. Property window, and you can start writing. You'll find some empty pages also in the notes. You see, after this page or before this page, you'll find empty page. Hey, left or right? Hey, na right side me. You can use. You can use any empty page. And all the notes directly updated in the notes only. Don't use separate notes, because you'll find page below. You see, above some space, below some space. No, don't use that, because few new points related to the latest version that directly can update in the printed notes. Okay, no need to maintain separate. Okay, so you'll find some empty pages also in between the modules like this. So in that empty page, you can write first point, properties. Properties. And you see, property in bracket, you can write PP. What is PP? PP is a command. But where is a command window? So remember, in Revit there is no command window. But still, commands will work. So PP is a command, and no need to go for even enter also. Like in AutoCAD, after command we'll put enter or space bar, no? But here, and remember, in Revit you'll find each command with a combination of two letters. You don't find any single letter in Revit. So simply, you see, I'm going to click somewhere here. There is no command window, so click on the working area and type. You see, when I type PP, again I'm typing window left side, this property window is on. When I type PP, it's off. Means command will work in Revit without command window, and each command with the combination of two alphabets. Okay, clear? So PP is a command to switch on and off the command window. But apart from this, we have the option also. Click on the view. Don't write. You'll find in the notes. Click on the view. You see, under user interface drop down, from here also you can switch on and off. Switch off, switch on. Right? Very basic. But this property window, if I take this out, this consists of three sections. So under property PP, make a sub points 1, 2 and 3. This I'm considering, say, point A, and this you can write element property drop down or type selector. Element property drop down or type selector. I'll explain this, don't worry. Next, this section, the second point, this is called edit type or type properties. Edit type or type properties. And this area, this complete. Listen, from here graphic, you can scroll down. So all this section, all this area, all this window is called instance. Instance properties. Now the detail. If you talk about this 3D view here, this area, element property drop down. Why we are calling element property drop down? Can I erase this? You see, why we are calling element property drop down. For example, if I select this duct and when I click this option, you'll find the types of duct. Similarly, if I select the pipe, you'll find the pipes and you'll find the types of pipe. Okay, so that's the reason we used to call a type selector. We can select the type as per the requirement of the particular component, or also known as element property drop down or type selector. Type selector because you can select the types na? Also known as element property drop down. Okay, means element properties also will get in this. For example, if I click on the screen, the screen is 3D view, so I'll get the property of this screen na? Or if you select the component, it will become drop down. Okay, first section. Second, edit type. So what is edit type? Under edit type, point B na, you can write hyphen, means dash, like this. You see element property type selector hyphen, you can write component properties. Component properties means, for example, suppose if I select this A terminal, this is a grill na? When I select this here and click edit type, this property like width, height, half width, etc., like manufacturer information model, all this property belongs to a particular component only. Okay, following. So component property means edit type. You can able to edit also as per the requirement, but we have design properties also with respect to the component. For example, the friction, the flow rate, velocity, all these are design properties now for that particular component. So design property you'll find under this instance properties. So point C, so you have written instance properties. So under instance properties, you can write hyphen and write design property of component. For example, you see, now if I select this A terminal here, this side, this options are changing na? Remember, this property window will change as per your selection. Okay, now you see level 1 offset supply, this is a supply diffuser, okay, or supply grill, and static pressure is given, flow is given. So all this property belongs to the design na? Type of, you see, diffuser means diffuser, we can use for supply or return. So supply or return means that belongs to design, and this flow rate, the static pressure, all this related design property na? So design property means instance property. Only the property of component means edit type, and the type selector you'll find here. So these are the three sections under property window, and you can on and off by typing PP. Okay, simple. And till the end, for all the services we'll use this, we'll use this property window. So this is important, and we'll not switch off this. Okay, just we'll switch on and we'll place on the left side, and as per the requirement we'll use to update the instance property, edit types or type selector, etc. Till then, for all the services. Okay, below this you'll find one more very important. Here you'll find this window, I'll take this out. This window is called, you can read here, project browser. And as I said at the beginning, in Revit we are dealing with the project na, not files like AutoCAD. So here you'll find the idea. You see, when I expand this, under this you'll find the services like HVAC, plumbing, power. So these views are design views, and views are multiple for the same project, for the same building, but project is only one. But in AutoCAD, different services, different CAD files. But here in Revit, only one 3D intelligent building, but multiple views. For example, first floor used by HVAC people, electrical, plumbing, etc. So first floor is first floor only, but views are multiple to avoid confusion at the time of working in the same project. But it's not separate files. And how to access the views? We can access views from the project browser. This used for design. Similarly, legend views, schedule views, reports, sheets, all this you can find in the project browser. At this level, just get the idea. When we use in the project, you can understand more about this views. So remember, in Revit we are dealing with one project but multiple views of the same areas. For example, this is a 3D intelligent component. If I see from the top, this is a plan view na? If I see from the side, this is side view, means elevation. If I cut it, that will be section. So I'll create a copy of this view. But creating copy of this views means, don't think there's like a multiple files like AutoCAD. Views are multiple of same component, of same floor, or of the same duct or the same HU. So multiple views but of the same component. Okay, so why multiple views? To avoid confusion. For example, first floor with the only one view, if all the services people are working with, that will create a lot of confusion, na? In case of coordination, we can switch on and off, that is different. But the time of working for the same first floor will take a copy of view to deal with the HVAC, as electrical will take a copy of same first floor to deal with electrical. So copy of the views, not the files, of the same area, and all this comes under one 3D intelligent building, one file. So now you can understand, in Revit we are not dealing with the files, we are dealing with the project, and all the user file is connected with the central file. But how, that we'll discuss at the time of learning central file concept. Okay, so anyhow, at this level, this is a separate window. You see, this is a separate window. You see, I have picked this, na, property is here. This is a property window, and project is a separate window, and we can switch on and off. Again, user interface, you see, project browser, switch off, and you can switch on. And there is no default command for this from Revit, but if you want, you can create the our own commands also. But there is no default command for project browser. For property, default command is pp. So you see, project browser is important. We'll use till the end for all the services to access the views. For example, if you want to work on the plan view, we can access the plan view from the project browser. If you want to access the 3D view, all these views we can access from the project browser. And we also learn how to create these views. And for that reason, first of all, you must know how to link the 3D intelligent building to your project. Then we can create the multiple views. So we have a separate topic for that, creating views. At this level, just learn the idea about the project browser. So this is also important. In the project browser, you'll find the views, legends, legend for all the services, schedule quantities, this is specially for metal takeoff, next panel schedule for electrical, reports for HVAC, sheets. At the end, we'll put all the views on the sheet to take the printout to start work on site, family components. You see, these are the family component for all the services by default from the software, including the pipe, duct, etc. Next, groups in Revit means block. They go in like in AutoCAD, block means, for example, if I use different lines, circle, rectangle, and finally I'll create that as a one component. In AutoCAD we used to call it as a block, na? But here in Revit we used to call group. But remember, group is different and 3D intelligent component is different. Group is just like a drawing, like AutoCAD, a set of the tools. And finally, link file is like XREF. Do you know XREF in AutoCAD? External reference. So we'll use external reference file in our project, na? The architect, generally the civil plan will take as external reference to deal with the ducting piping, but here in Revit we used to call link. And we are not going to link the CAD file, that also possible, that is different case, but here link means we are going to link 3D intelligent building from architect. 3D intelligent building. So 3D intelligent building will prepare by whom? The architect, again using software, Revit software. That project will link in this project or in our project to deal with the services. And the first step before starting the project, which is common for all the services, linking the architectural project, the link. So when you link, you can confirm here under this. Okay, so this is just an idea for project browser, just an idea, not in detail we'll discuss when we deal with the project. Okay. Yes, separate services, separate views. And again, you see, under HVAC you'll find the ducting views, piping views, legends, nodes. We can create multiple of the same area. So how we'll discuss. Next, this area, this is called model view or working area, but technically it's a model view. Why? Because we used to deal with the modeling, na? In Revit, you see, in Revit we have a separate view for drawing, that is called drafting view. Then we need to activate under the view tab. You see, under the view tab you'll find the separate option for drafting view here. So that is a separate option only for drafting. But in general, in Revit we are dealing with the modeling, so the present view on screen is called model view. Okay, because these are all model components. This duct is a model component, this grill, this AHU, these are all model components. So this area is called model view. Okay, by default we have a separate drafting view also, that we'll discuss later. but in general it's a model view. All these views from the project browser left side, in that the major is the model views only. Or model views mean, in short, if you are dealing any model component in the view, that view is called model view. Okay, next, on the right side of this screen, can you see this box? It's visible. This is called view cube. Okay, why we used to call view cube? And when you open 3D view only, you'll find this. In plan, you'll not find this. You see, when I click this corner, you'll get the corner view. When I select this face, you'll get the face view. When you select this edge, you'll get the edge view. So this is called view cube. And by default, when you click this home button, you'll get northwest 3D view, default view. Okay, after changing, if you want to change to the normal, click this home button. So this is only for visibility for views. Below this, from 1:100 till this icon, this is called view control toolbar. I think it's given in the notes. View control toolbar. Okay, and you see it's given drawing area. Okay, in general drawing area is okay, but you can write slash model view. Finally, at the bottom, this is called status toolbar. But with the status toolbar, you'll get one more information. For example, you see, you can just watch this site. It's visible, no? Again, okay. Anyhow, it's partially visible. So when I take the cursor close to this, you see the information is changing, no? Left side. It's changing. Now, it is showing duct. And when I go near to this A terminal, you're getting A terminal. When I take near to this machine, mechanical equipment, so this is called tooltip information. As per the cursor location, you'll find the information here. So if you're new to any service, if you are having confusion in the component, just take the cursor close to this, you can read the information. And one more point, when I take the cursor close to this, this is highlighting, na? This highlighting means this is called pre-selection. Pre-selection. This is important. Or else you see thin line. I'm going to zoom this. Suppose when I take the cursor close to this. Okay, still confusion. This pipe. When I take close to this, it's highlighting, na? This is called pre-selection. And when you click, this is called selection. Okay. Similarly, you see this is pre-select. Click to select. So this point also important. At the time of working, we have options for pre-selection and selection. Sometime pre-selection is required for some tools, or generally we use selection. So, and the bottom completely is called status toolbar. So this is just a idea for what is what on screen. Okay, so what you do now, because this is very basic, you must spend time, sit in the lab, open the software, and just go through once, learn the just play with the software, thoda experiment kare, thoda just close this and again try to open this and just click these options and read these options to get the idea. Just get familiar with the software. Okay, so to start the first exercise from tomorrow. Okay, so just spend time. Spending time is very important with the software. So today just get some idea about the screen and go through once about this file format. Okay, so done for today.